Hey, thanks for clicking on the extended version of my cast interviews for the film Touched with Fire. I was really impressed by this movie. I knew nothing about it before I saw it. It is very moving. It's very emotional, actually, and I had a chance to sit down with Katie Holmes, Luke Kirby, and the director who based this on some of the things that he went through, Paul Dalio.
Been taking your medication?
I found that they really weren't working for me.
I know that it's always exhausting acting and you've got a long day of shooting, but when you're playing characters like these characters, going from highs to lows, how exhausted are you guys by the end of the day?
Well, it depended on the day, and I think like it was an interesting character to take on, and I have lots of notebooks full of notes of trying to map out, you know, when it's high, when it's low, and finding the different levels. And
yeah, better to be exhausted having, you know, wrestled through something in your day than to just be exhausted because
of traffic.
Yeah.
Did you guys become more creative after this? Like you mentioned parts where you're so free. Are you all now back at home painting, writing more? Like, did it spur some of that in you?
I'm very lazy by nature, so no.
Having Paul though on set, when you've got a director who has lived this, helpful, almost too much, what was that like?
We had to sort of, you know, walk a line and figure out where we were going. Paul's story is very, very personal and specific, and it's been a huge, you know, he's really had to fight hard to, you know.
And our job was to create characters that we could inhabit. So it was, you know, being inspired by his story, but also being strong in our own performances to say, no, I have to take on this person now. You gotta trust me with this.
That was right before I got sick. Remember?
Tough movie to talk about in 4 minutes, but I'll do my best. Obviously, your story is incredible. So you're shooting this thing and you're seeing these actors essentially play what you've gone through. How exposed did you feel once shooting started? Was it a different feeling?
I was dying to be exposed because I was misunderstood by judging eyes or eyes that saw me in a defective way. So it was more like bringing to light something that I felt trapped in the darkness with.
And of all the films I've ever seen, and not many of them touch on this subject, it explained it, in my opinion, the best. Because at the end of the day, there is that debate, is it a gift, is it a disease? And honestly, you can go either way on that, in my opinion. It was so well done.
Thank you.
What do you think? At the end of the day, is it both?
I think it can be a curse or a gift, depending on how you handle it.
How long did it take you to figure things out? It
took a long time. I used to first be lost, not knowing it was a gift. Then I discovered the book Touched with Fire, and I found the gift in it. But then I romanticized the gift in it, and it destroyed me and brought me to near suicide. But then, finally, learning that I can actually, it is like a fire, and the fire can get out of control and burn your mind down and leave your life in ashes. Or if you find the right balance of medication and other things like meditation and, you know, then you can allow the fire to sustain and rein it in and keep it from burning down your mind, but keep it alive to the point where now I feel much richer, deeper emotion than I ever did before bipolar.
I have a really good plan. You're gonna spend the night tonight, and then tomorrow morning, first thing, we'll go to the hospital and get your file. And you can ask anything, okay? We'll figure all this out.
Hey, Christine, you know, what's interesting, I kept watching the film thinking, in a weird way, how fortunate are Katie and Luke's characters to have parents that were patient and struggled so much with what to say and how to approach it, and anything could set them off.
That's right, yeah. I had a lot of personal experience with this. My sister was bipolar and struggled with the disease for over 25 years and eventually took her life.
Oh, wow.
So I understood the roller coaster of this disease. My sister's bipolar was extreme. It was, her mania was psychotic. It wasn't even that she could function when she was manic. And her depression was severely depressed. They could never find the right cocktail of medication for her. But anyway, she was incredibly brave and resilient and the strongest person I've ever met. that gave me a lot of understanding of this, of Katie's character, so I didn't have to really do much homework.
The heartbreak was significant, but, you know, as an actor, that's what a great thing. You know, stuff you would really hate in life is what you hope for on screen or on stage. So it was a wonderful opportunity.
Medication is not going to take your personality away. It's not going to take your own gift. It's a fire when it's out of control. And what medication can do is to kind of tamp that down a bit without losing that gift.
Did you go through that fear too?
Oh, yeah. And everyone does, because no one knows.
Right.
I remember I was asking my doctor, can you introduce me to one person who's bipolar, who's creative on meds? And he couldn't produce anybody. Mm. It was only then that I met Kay Jamison, because he happened to be a friend of Kay Jamison's, and she's the one person he knew who was happy and creative on meds.
And yet Luke in the movie, I think kind of, because I almost felt the same way after watching his struggle. He meets her and he leaves and he goes, she's kind of copped out. She's taken the easy route out. Like, she is different than what I envisioned her. So you even address it then.
Yeah, it's funny because that's an actual dialogue thought that I had going in my mind when I first realized that she actually was against the medication. And at the same time, she told me, I love that dialogue that you write about when I'm saying that, you know, you can't, because she knew it was real. She knew that she would be doing the same thing.
And they meet in a psych ward, essentially. What's the craziest place that you all have met someone and shared kind of a unique connection, whether it's a friend or a significant other, whoever? It's kind of a crazy place where you met someone and there was a connection.
I've always found bus stations to be pretty prime for that kind of thing.
Got a lot of friends.
A lot of the time they're just strangers, but they happen to act like friends.
Yeah, there you go.
That for me, that's the first one that came to mind.
Don't say Starbucks.
No.
Starbucks.
I find I connect with people in many different places. It's usually, like in this stage in my life, it's usually regarding like a child event. And sometimes that really is at the most random place. But you can meet your greatest friends there.
Did you guys actually paint at all? Did you save any of the painting?
Did you paint? No.
We
but he jumped in the river in the freezing cold in Utah. Mm. I didn't.
Katie and Luke have such chemistry that then rumors get started the two are dating. I would think at the time you're like, this might help our film. This might be good for us, this publicity.
I just thought, like, I don't get caught up. I try not to get caught up in the tabloids and stuff, but they both became the characters, you know? And the characters were written to be explosive off each other, so once they became the characters and they got together, they just developed this intense chemistry that was creating this explosive, passionate love, you know, just effortlessly.
The closer to each other they moved, the brighter they shined. As we race through the days, on that flame.
Again, this is not a blockbuster movie. It's not Deadpool or The Avengers, but it's a charming film. I really liked it. A Touch with Fire in theaters. Don't forget to like us on Facebook. Harkins Theaters for your movie news, promotions, and giveaways. And of course, we'll see you at the movies.